the prior provincial, the reverend fathers, the religious sisters and brothers and sisters in Christ, and you, our dear ordinance. Until now, I cannot get over the fact that we are ordaining the day after New Year. I don't know why, but God must have a reason. Because I make an act of faith that even before God created the sun, the moon, and the stars, even before God created the first man and woman, God already knew that on the second day of the year 2023, you will receive ordination. So this is not just about availability. This is not just about your planning. This is about God's design. This is about destiny. Inasmuch as you will receive ordination to the diaconate and priesthood on the second day of the year, let us reflect on number two. Let us reflect on being second. You could not be ordained on the 1st of January because you were not destined to be number one. Your vocation is always to be number two. And the counting stops there. There is no more number three. In other words, in your life, it is God who is first. In your lives, it is the church. In your lives, it is the poor. It is the youth. All of these are first in your life. And you are only secondary. If you belong to the order of preachers, it is not because you are good preachers, but only because you are good echoes. Secondary voice of the primary voice, who is Jesus Christ. You are not destined to be number one. Your destiny is to be always number two, and nothing else follows after the second. In other words, you are not the first, you are the second, but you are not on top of somebody else because number two is just the last number. As a deacon, as a priest, you are being called to serve. And please remember, my dear brothers, two is not greater than one. Your math teacher taught you the other way. Your math teacher taught you that two is greater than one. But in the kingdom of God, one is greater than two, and two can never be greater than one. Because the way to number one, the way to God, the way to heaven, the way to greatness is always downward. The way to greatness is to fall down on your knees, take the basin with water and towel, and wash the feet of your brethren. The way to greatness is kenosis. You know that from your studies. The way to greatness is by emptying. Because when you're so full of yourself, when you are so convinced that you are number one, when you're so convinced that you are privileged and entitled and way above the rest, champions, then you're missing the whole point. You are only being called to follow. You are not called to be lords. You are only being called to be disciples. You are not called to be masters. You are being called to be echoes of the word. You are not the word. You are not the voice. God is. In your life, let the truth be proclaimed, the truth for the coming of Jesus Christ. What is the truth? That there is God. And as you declare there is God, please declare under the same breath, I am not God. You are not God. Even if people treat you almost like their gods, you are only second. You are not the first. You are not number one. And two, I say it again, is not greater than one. Two must always follow one. That is your vocation. To be a priest, to be a deacon, looking always, fixing your eyes, your heart, your mind on the real and only number one, and it is the Lord. But there is still something about number two. Hegel taught you thesis and antithesis. When you're given two options, the two options eventually cause you stress. As the stress between the left and the right, as the stress between the north and the south, as the stress between the east and the west, as the stress between the man and the woman, as the stress between the body and the soul, as the stress between the spiritual and the material, as the stress between the church and the state, all of these are stressful. Psychologists call that stress. Modern man calls that stress. Christ does not call that stress. Christ calls that discipleship. If you're dreaming of a stress-free life, you can quit now. Because as you are destined to be deacons and eventually priests, as you're destined to be a priest, Andre, you must remember, when God says, come follow me, God actually says, come die with me. And dying will always be stressful. You're going to live in community, but you're going to live without a wife. You're going to live without children of your own. It is going to be stressful. I am sure you have felt it. I am sure you have experienced it. Because we are being asked to live what God Himself condemned in the book of Genesis. It is not good for man to be alone. And here we are. We are living alone. But it is for a purpose. Because God told us, this is our cross. And we will carry it cheerfully, we will carry it courageously, we will carry it faithfully up to the very end. Celibacy may be unnatural, I agree. Celibacy may be difficult, I accept. But celibacy is a gift that God gives. And you can live this commitment in the priesthood and in the diaconate by the grace of God. In the choice between popularity and hiddenness, in the choice between power and weakness, in the choice between pleasure and sacrifice, the choice is always clear. Let it not cause you stress, because in between the two options, you will find the Lord. Dominus est. It is the Lord. It is the Lord that you will find in between your stress. It is the Lord that you will find nailed to the cross. It is the Lord you will find walking with you as you carry the weight of the heavy cross. And the beautiful reality, my dear brothers, is this. While you are all number two, we are many who are number two. I am number two with you. The brethren are number two with you. And if you like to learn how to be number two, allow us to teach you. Allow us to guide you. We will walk with you every step along the way. In this discipleship that is a call to be secondary, in this discipleship that is a call to stress, to tension, to carrying the cross daily, to kenosis, to self-emptying. Never, never consider yourself alone, because you have the brethren to teach you to always look at our number one. You have the brethren to teach you to always consider yourself second, and we cannot be greater than that rank. We look forward to many years of service in this ministry as deacons and as priests. Andre and dear brethren, if there should come a time when the weight of the cross would be too heavy and you're tempted to say, why can I not be number one? If there should come a time when looking at your ordination pictures will bring a lump to your throat and questions in your mind, if there should come a time when you would be tempted to ask questions like, was it right? Did I discern well? Maybe I made a mistake. Maybe I should try another life. Before you make any decision, please come over. We can talk together. And we can talk to God together. I know that God who blesses you now will bless you again and again. We look forward to your ordination as priests in His time. We look forward to many years of ministry as a priest. We look forward to many happy, beautiful, faithful years ahead of you. Relax. You're not meant to be number one. You're meant to be number two, and always under the shadow of the Lord. Relax. Even if there are only two choices, virtue is in the middle. And in the middle of the choices, it is the Lord. Between the progressives and the conservatives, between the left and the right, between the man and the woman, in the body and in the soul, it is the Lord who will walk with you, who will accompany you. May God's will be done in your life, so that at the sunset of your life, the same voice, the same primary voice that you heard, the same word that you proclaimed, will welcome you into the kingdom of the Father and say, welcome, good and faithful, secondary servant. Enter your everlasting reward. May God's will be done. May God's glory shine forth in your life. Amen.